through the period of maximum aerodynamic pressure. As the velocity increases, the depth of the atmosphere is decreasing. Lessening stress on the vehicle. The call-out next inbound. Continuing to watch the first stage as we head downrange. Seconds into flight. Our next major activity is going to be set down of the first stage. Houston Tracking Station now acquiring the vehicle. We set down, we will get separation of Starship and Super Heavy and additional Starship engines. When Starship separates, we light up six engines in a staggered sequence. If all goes well, those six engines will burn for almost 6.5 minutes. Onboard view from Starship. And there's views of the Raptor engines on the second stage as we prepare for stage separation. Now after stage separation, the first stage will flip and begin a boost back maneuver for landing in the Gulf. Continuing to fly, 2 minutes 40 seconds, let's get ready for main engine cutoff. Beginning the flip for stage separation.
We are awaiting stage separation. Our Starship should separate from the Super Heavy booster.
Yeah, Kate, right now it looks like we saw the start of the flip, but obviously we're seeing from the ground cameras the entire Starship stack continuing to rotate. We should have had separation by now. Obviously, this is does not appear to be a nominal situation.
Yeah, it does appear to be spinning, but I do want to remind everyone that everything after clearing the tower was icing on the cake. Live view there of our control center at Starbase, which we refer to as Star Command. As we said before, obviously we wanted to make it all the way through, but to get this far, honestly, is amazing.
Well, if you're just joining us, Starship just experienced what we call a rapid unscheduled disassembly, or a RUD, during ascent. But now this was a development test. This is the first test flight of Starship, and the goal was to gather the data, and as we said, clear the pad and get ready to go again. So you never know exactly what's going to happen, but as we promised, excitement is guaranteed. And Starship gave us a rather spectacular end to what was truly an incredible test thus far.
Now, as we mentioned at the start of today's program, any and all the data that we collected during the test is going to help us with further development of Starship, and it's going to improve the vehicle's reliability as SpaceX seeks to make life multiplanetary. It's really worth noting that the flight...
Okay, so we have been waiting, as you have been waiting, to find out whether or not it worked, and I think we can say partial success.
Yes.
I think...